Now, decorators have changed in TypeScript version 5 as compared to version 4, and that's primarily because there is an upcoming proposal to include decorators as an ECMAScript feature. Now, you'll get to see this kind of decorator pattern used a lot in AngularJS as well as frameworks like Nest.js, and these decorators are super helpful. Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to talk about and understand what decorators are in TypeScript along with decorator factories in TypeScript. So that's kind of the topic here. And I'll be posting the link to this particular web page in the description below for you to refer later as well. So if you see here, it states that decorators are a powerful and an expressive feature which are borrowed from a decorator pattern in languages such as Python. So there is a proposal to implement decorators in ECMAScript as well, and it's been going on for a while, and we will talk about that as well in this particular video. So let's start by understanding or getting the definition of decorators. So decorators are a special kind of declaration that can be attached to a class and a method of a class, property, or a parameter of the method of the class to modify their behavior or add metadata to them. So what this tells us is that decorators are primarily available for classes in TypeScript and properties and methods that are related to classes. Before we see at an example of a decorator, let's just look at various places we can actually use a decorator. So a decorator can be used along with a class and the methods of a class. And when we say method, it also includes accessors and modifiers, the properties of the class, as well as the parameters of the methods of a class. So these are the four places where you can actually use a decorator function. Now, before we write some code, let's have a look at how decorators have changed in TypeScript version 5. Now, decorators have changed in TypeScript version 5 as compared to version 4, and that's primarily because there is an upcoming proposal to include decorators as an ECMAScript feature. So in this video, we would be looking at a class decorator, how to declare that in TypeScript, and how it has changed for you if you're using TypeScript version 5 instead of version 4. So now, in order to see what decorators are, let's just open this TypeScript playground. And I'm using the playground just because I can easily switch between TypeScript versions and show you what's the difference between a decorator when it was written in version 4.x as compared to what's the difference when it's written in version 5.x. So let's start with version 4.x. Let's get rid of this boilerplate code over here. So as we discussed earlier, that decorators can only be used with a class. What we can do over here is declare a class. So let's declare a class and let's call that my class. So this is an empty class in TypeScript as of now. Let me just increase the size of the font here. So we have a simple class. And remember that we are writing decorators for version 4.x. So a decorator is just a function with some special arguments passed to it. So we can declare a function over here. Let's declare a function and let's call this function as log class. So we have this log class function. Now, since this is a decorator, it's going to get a target. So this is the default parameter that is passed to a decorator. Now, I'll just explain in a while why I'm using a function type for this particular target over here. So in version 4.x, whenever a decorator function is declared, that decorator function gets a default parameter, and that parameter is the target. Now, you can name this anything. In our case, I can call it as constructor as well, because this is going to be the constructor function. Now, based on where you apply this decorator to a class, to a method of a class, to parameter of a method of a class, this target would vary, and also the number of parameters that you would get by default in a decorator would change. So since we are applying this log class decorator to our class, what we're going to get is the constructor function of the class. And that's the reason why we are assigning this function type to our parameter, that is the constructor. So we're going to get the constructor function along with this decorator. Now, in order to apply this decorator to our class, all we have to do is use the @rate symbol and then just call the decorator. Now, this particular decorator log class has been applied to my class over here. Let's just open the logs. Now, what we can do over here is that we get the constructor of the class within our decorator. So let's just log this constructor to the console and see what we get. So console log constructor. And once we've done that, let's just run our script and see what we get. So now you see that the entire class constructor has been logged to our console, since constructor functions are actually syntactic sugar over classes. So you get the entire class over here logged inside the decorator. Now, the important thing about decorator functions is that they execute only once, and they are executed during the compilation time of TypeScript. Now, remember I said that decorator functions are different in version 4.x as compared to version 5.x. So let's just switch to version 5.x and let's see if this decorator works or not. Now you'll see that the moment I switch my version from 4.x to 5.x, I do get an error over here. And this error states that the signature of the decorator does not match the expression. So why we're getting this error is because in version 5.x, instead of getting just one parameter in our decorator function, we actually get two. So the second parameter that is passed to the decorator is the context. And let's say that this is type of any for the moment. Now you'll see that this error has gone away because we have passed in the second parameter that the decorator function is supposed to have. And the signature of the decorator function matches the kind of parameter TypeScript is expecting over here. Let's open our logs. And what we can do is we can console log the context as well and see what we get. So let's just run our script now. Now you'll see that instead of getting a specific constructor, we are getting the entire class. In version 4.x, we were actually getting the constructor function. So we can rename this to any. And along with the class, we are also getting the context. So here it's telling us what is the kind of a decorator. So it's a class decorator. Had it been the decorator applied on the method of a class, we would have got a kind of method decorator over here. And then it's telling us what is the name of the class. So if it's a kind of class, the name of the class is my class. Now, if this class has certain properties, we would also get those properties within this context that we get from the new decorators in TypeScript version 5. So let's add a constructor function, and let's say that we are going to take a variable, a property inside constructor. Let's take a public property, and this property is going to be name, and this can be a kind of a string. Now let's run our code and see what we get. Now you will see our console log statement clearly defines the structure of our class as well. So it tells that this is a class which has a constructor function, and then there is a property which is name being instantiated inside the constructor function as well. Let's clear the logs. So you can start looking at the power of decorators over here. You get the entire class within the decorator as well as the context or the metadata related to that particular class. And you can actually make changes to the class within this decorator itself. So if there are any properties that you want to add to the class, or if there are any properties that you want to remove from the class, or filter out any properties from the class, all that can be done inside decorator functions. And since decorators run during the compilation time, the decorator would have executed by the time JavaScript runs. So any changes you make inside the decorator would have an impact on the JavaScript that is emitted out by this particular TypeScript file, or to be specific to this particular class in TypeScript. Now, there might be instances where you want to take some kind of an argument while executing this decorator, like so, and then use that argument inside the decorator itself. In order to do that, what you have to create is called a decorator factory. A decorator factory is nothing but a function that takes some arguments and in the end returns a decorator function. So let's declare a new function, and let's call that function as log class factory. So function log class factory. And within this function, let's take the last name, and this will be a type of a string. This particular function acts as a higher order function. So basically, it will encapsulate your decorator function. And from within this higher order function, you are going to return this decorator function. Now, this itself is called as a decorator factory. There's nothing else that you have to do. Now, instead of calling log class, what we can do is we can call the log class factory with our class. And then we can pass a string as an argument, let's say dough. And within our decorator function, that is the log class, we get access to this particular string that we have passed here. So you can have multiple parameters here. So you can have, say, last name, age, etc. So there can be multiple parameters. You can also take objects as parameters to a decorator factory. And then you can use those objects, strings, numbers, whatever inside your decorator as well. So here, what we can do is we can duplicate this console log statement. Let's just duplicate this. And over here, let's use last name. So now you will see that we have applied a decorator factory to our class. And when we run this, we would get this particular value that we have passed as an argument to our decorator factory inside the decorator function. So let's run this script. And over here, you'll see that we get the class. We have console logged the class over here. Then we get the context, which is right here. And finally, we get the last name as well, that is Doe. Now you can use this value again to manipulate your class and add properties, remove properties based on whatever value was passed by the user when invoking this particular decorator factory. Now you'll get to see this kind of decorator pattern used a lot in AngularJS as well as frameworks like NestJS. And these decorators are super helpful. Certain libraries like TypeORM also implement these decorator functions, and you can use them to create various database schema. But that's kind of a topic for another video. On a side note, I do have a TypeScript course that I offer on Udemy, and here's the curriculum of the course. In this course, I take you from beginner level TypeScript to advanced, and I talk about in detail about decorators as well in TypeScript in this particular course. Apart from decorators, there are other topics, and we work on a backend and a frontend project as well. This course has more than 20 hours of content and is worth looking at. So if you are interested, I have the link to the course along with the discount coupon in the description below. That's all about decorators. Thanks for watching.